to show you how using a combo box can change many aspects of your sheet. To install a combo box, you need to have the developer tab on your screen. So what you can do is you can just right click on your screen here, and you can go customize ribbon, and then you just ensure that the checkbox is next to the developer tab. And then once you do that, you say okay, and then you have your developer tab up here. So let's go to the developer tab. Let's go to our insert, and we're going to take the second one here, which is our combo box. Now, what I'm going to do is I am going to go and I'm going to press the Alt key, and then I'm going to draw it over A7 here. Oops. So that, let's increase the size a little bit so we can do it. Now, what we need to do is we need to format that. So what we're going to do is we're going to right click and we're going to format control. And so what I have here is I have a little fictitious Canadian camping adventures. And so now what I have done on the second sheet is I've created a list of items to bring depending on what season you're coming in. So in the input range, I am going to minimize this by pressing the little red arrow. I'm going to go to sheet 2 and I'm going to select winter and summer. Then I'm going to click on my red arrow again. And now we want the results of that displayed where, and I'm going to select this cell right beside, so that would be B7. And I'm going to say OK. So now let's click away, so we're finished with formatting that. And so let's select winter, and it produces a 1, and summer, and it produces a 2. Now, let's tell these people what they need to bring if it's winter or summer. So what we're going to do is we're going to do an index. So we'll go equals index, and we'll do an opening bracket, and then we're going to go, it's asking for an array, and so what we're going to go to sheet 2, and we're going to select all of the cells here that we have our items in that we'd like them to bring. And so that's our array, and so now we're going to put a comma. And what we're going to do is go back to sheet 1, basing on what, and so we want it based on what never comes up here. And I'm going to F4 that to absolute it because we don't want it to change. And we'd like it to bring up column 1 of that table. So we're going to put a 1 in here. And we're going to close the brackets and press enter. So in the summer, the first thing you need to do is you need to bring good walking shoes for a camping trip. So so we're going to drag this across. We've got this this here absoluted, so it should work. So let's drag that across. Good waterproof jacket. And now let's drag it across the last one. And the extras you need to bring is sunscreen, bug repellent, and bathing suit. So let's see. Let's go back to our combo box and let's select winter. And now the footwear is warm winter boots, warm jacket, gloves, hats, scarves. So that's how that's done. Now, let's say we wanted to relate it to something else. So we're going to put in here, we're going to put, when are you coming? Okay, and then we're going to go to this cell here, and then we're going to go to data, and data validation, and we're going to enter list. Now, because when I named these ranges, I had to name them. I couldn't name them one or two because those are reserved letters or numbers. So I had to name them WIN and SUM. So I'm going to do an if function in this field here. So I'll go equals if, and I'm going to put an opening bracket, and I'm going to select that one, and I'm going to F4 that. Now, if that equals 1, we are going to display the list for winter, so WIN. And if it doesn't equal 1, it has to equal 2, which is sum. So we'll say OK to that. And so they've said winter here. So let's see when they're coming. You're coming December, January, or February. And let's say for summer. And then we will drop down the list of June, July, or August. Their named ranges were named here. So this is our win, and this is our sum. So that is how you can use a combo box to change many aspects of your sheet. Please subscribe.